I've done dreadful things. Monstrous things. And there will be a price.
I was shooting Easy Virtue for Ealing Studios, and the producer, Barnaby Thompson, came up to me and handed me a gift and said, I've got something for you. And I opened it up, and it was a copy of Oscar Wilde's Dorian Gray. And I said, oh, that's great, thanks, but I've read it. And he said, well, we're going to make a film of it. I said, that's great, who's going to play Dorian Gray? And he said, well, I was hoping maybe you might. And I said, okay, well, what do I have to do? And he said, well, you've got to meet the director, Oliver Parker, and I did two auditions for him. And about 5 minutes after the second one, I was just about to get on the tube in London, and he called me and said, do you want to be Dorian Gray? And I said, yes, please. And that was that, really. It was too great an opportunity and a challenge to pass up. It's just such a fantastic, timeless story, and I absolutely had to kind of take it on, really.
I just
sort of wondered at the, especially for when it was written as well, just how much it was, how shocking it was, and how much it was kind of teasing with its themes, really. It's all very subtextual, but it's just such a simple story on the surface in terms of a young man makes the Faustian pact so that he can stay young, and the painting will age and represent the depravity of his soul, whilst no scars or blemishes will be left on him. And so the premise is a very exciting one, but everything that it entails and everything that it sort of leads to, and how it affects him and the society around him and people's attitudes towards him is really interesting.
Well, the ice was broken quickly, and it had to be. I mean, that was their scheduling was, I don't know whether they did it on purpose to kind of break the ice on purpose or not, but I arrived Monday morning, and usually, you know, you'll turn up and go in your trailer and your costume will be hanging up, and there was nothing hanging up. So you just sort of walked onto set in a dressing gown, and hopefully some small piece of flesh-colored material to cover your modesty, if you're lucky. So I had to shoot the love scene with Rachel Hurd-Wood's character, Sybil Vane, on the very, very first Monday morning. So yeah, it's an interesting experience, but there are worse places to be on a Monday morning.
This is not my true face.